Hello everyone, and welcome to today's video. My name is Andrea Togni, and I am a MATLAB student ambassador at the University of Bologna. Today, we are going to talk about the programming of Arduino using Simulink, especially how to deploy our code to the board and how to receive data in real time. If you are here now, you are probably wondering, how do I connect Arduino to Simulink? So, let me explain that in a few words before I show you. All you need to do is start Simulink, design the model you want to run, and then simply deploy the model itself on the board. The automatic code generation of Simulink will think about the rest. Of course, you can also decide to export the results to MATLAB if you want to further process them after. For those of you who are not familiar with Arduino, all you need to know is that Arduino is an affordable microcontroller board, which is widely used for homemade projects, from sensors to small robotics. In our case, Arduino becomes an extension of our programming environment, allowing us to sense and interact with the physical world, using both sensors and actuators. Of course, by only using a board, we cannot get far. Fortunately for us, the Arduino environment is completely modular, allowing us to explore different solutions to extend our work with Simulink to the physical world. For today's video, we will use an Arduino Uno, which will run the models we design on Simulink, a breadboard, which will be necessary to connect our elements to the board, simple jumper wires to create the circuits we will need, and finally a potentiometer to dynamically change the parameters of our circuits. Now, let's open up Simulink and start configuring it to deploy on our Arduino board. The first step is to verify in our library browser if we have installed the Simulink support package for Arduino hardware, which of course is required to deploy our code to the board itself. Now that we know that our Simulink is set up, we can start modeling. Our project will show the fundamentals of real-time acquisition without working with the IDE of Arduino. As you will see, with only three Simulink blocks, we will be able to record the circuit amperage and transmit it to MATLAB for further processing. Now, let's see how to connect our hardware. First, connect the Arduino to the USB port. Then, connect the potentiometer as shown. The orange and brown cables will connect the 5-volt port to the ground pin. The yellow cable then will connect the first analog input pin, 80. This way, you will be able to change the current through the circuit by rotating only the potentiometer. Now that the circuit is set, all we need to do is to design it on Simulink. First, let's go to Apps and then Run on Hardware Board. Finally, select the Arduino you will be using for your project. As you can see, now Simulink is ready to work with the board that we have selected. Now, let's create our model. Let's use an analog input block to receive the data from the A0 pin, as well as the sample time we want to use. Now we can apply an intermediate block to add some gain to our input. Finally, we can set up the two workspace block. This way, the received voltage will be transmitted directly to the computer via the USB port. After connecting everything, we also want to check the results in real time using a scope block. So we're running it to our model. Now we can run our model using the monitor and tune function. First, increase the stop time of the simulation to the infinite value. This way, we will be transmitting data to the computer until we manually stop the simulation. After we launch our simulation, all we need to do is wait for the deployment of the code itself on the board, and then we will be able to check out in real time the result of our coding. After the deployment is complete, we can double-click on the scope block to check the output of our model. Now, I am actively rotating the potentiometer to change the current going through the pin 80. This change is reflected in real time in the scope block and to the workspace block, making it possible to perform real-time acquisitions using Simulink. Now we can stop our simulation, and the result will be automatically sent to the workspace of MATLAB. Using the command on screen, it is possible then to simply plot the received data, showing it is the same as in the scope. So, in conclusion, the simulation is done in very simple steps. 1. Make the circuit. 2. Design the model on Simulink. 3. Monitor and tune our simulation. Step 4. Stop the simulation. And finally, the data will be ready for processing or saving in their computer memory. So, this concludes our video. Thank you for your attention. And if you found it useful, consider subscribing to our channel to keep up with future tutorials.